I'm Kannan. I look after HR for Baskin Robbins. What we're going to do today, or how I'm going to take you through this entire session, that probably for the next 15 minutes, is probably through my experience of setting up and developing leadership academies. Yeah, and also through some insights into the Indian executive education industry. So, just a second. So what is executive education? That's my first slide, and this is not a Google or a Wikipedia, but my experience and what I have learned from developing executive education in some of the companies that I work for. So it's more of a structured, formal approach targeted towards individuals aspiring or identified to be future leaders, and that's what we have been talking all this while today, starting from Anjali to Graham, is we're looking at developing leaders, or looking at people, or looking at developing high potentials in our organization. Yeah, and it helps individuals to develop their knowledge and skills holistically. That is, we look at an overall development, or we also look at some specific area of business where there needs to be an expertise in. Yeah. Now, there are different types of executive education. Now, executive education, as we all know, if I would have spoken about it a couple of years back, it would have been executive MBA. Yeah? But today, it has evolved. It has evolved into various different aspects like MDPs, the management development programs. Even there, we see now there are open programs run by institutes, and also there are customized programs which are available for organizations to use it for their employees. We also look at long-term executive education programs which run from 1 to 3 years, which are like MBAs, your PG diplomas, your certificate programs, etc. And one important aspect that I have put in here is executive coaching. Yeah? So like I said, how executive education is evolving, we are looking at a more strategic and a pinpoint development of top level executives. Yeah, and when that happens, executive coaching has an important role to play. And all these programs are now easily accessible through online or through classroom sessions. That's how executive education is evolving here today. Yeah, we look at executive education in India. Business Standard said executive education in India is a business of about 350 crores in June 2012. And June 2013, it stands at 500 crores. Right? One of the reasons being the education industry growing is because of the need that has been identified by organizations in putting that extra effort, doing that extra investment, and letting their executives do that extra bit of knowledge for their own growth and for the executives' growth as well. Yeah, we have a lot of inflow of foreign universities. Yeah, some of the major foreign universities who are running executive education in India is HBS, the Harvard Business School, Wharton School. Yeah, they're doing it very well in terms of executive education in India. We have Indian universities who are moving into it, Indian institutes. We have IIMs, we have the ISBs, we have Narsimhanji, SP Jain, who are moving into this segment because there is a lot of need and requirement identified by organizations. Yeah, we also have specialties. So we, like we said, about 2 years back, if I was to tell about executive education, it was executive MBA. Then came a time when there was part-time or executive MBAs offered in terms of HR, finance, IT, marketing, etc. Now we're looking at specific focused areas like leadership, corporate social responsibility, cyber laws, digital marketing, strategy and innovation. Yeah? So we're looking at developing our executives in specific focused areas of business. Right? We'll also look at how the bridge between these institutes and organizations and individuals is being filled through these organizations. We have NIIT Imperia, we have HugestNet. NIIT Imperia, for that matter, has started its own executive education courses. Yeah, we have HugestNet Global, we have Reliance, 24/7. Organizations are setting up their own universities. We have the Shiv Nadar University. We have Azim Premji Foundation, which are looking at developing their own people. And it has become very, very important that organizations focus towards executive education. Yeah? And the need for it. Why are organizations doing it? Yeah? It's for understanding that their very own existence, and this is basic, and it's, you know, probably the bullseye, is that their very own existence and business trajectory is based on sturdy leadership talent. And organizations have understood that. It's just not selling. It's about ensuring how my entire business structure functions. And we need a very good, sturdy leadership to ensure that it does. Yeah? Hypo or high potentials who will assume leadership roles need to be developed and trained. We have transformation required from manager to leader. Yeah? For example, I mean, one of my previous organizations where I started or where I did a leadership academy, the basic idea was to transform people from being just a manager to a leader. There were various different initiatives that we took, and out of that, one important or probably more than 50% of the role was played by an executive education initiative. Right? Rapidly changing business environment necessitates executive education for the C-suite and other top managers. Yeah. See, our top level employees or our top level executives do not have the time to regularly go on out and learn. So it becomes important that they are provided with whatever is required within the organization. And executive education is one such tool. Right. How are organizations using different kind of interventions? They call it by continuous education, leadership development, development centers, etc. Where the primary focus is on developing individuals and developing individuals to take on future roles. Some of the surveys, you know, this is one which is done by Avagma, which is a part of 24/7 learning. Which, you know, there are some anecdotes here which says companies use executive education as an effective rewards and recognition tool as a driver for performance, and companies are turning to management education to senior managers to acquire new range of skills, gain exposure, and enhance their knowledge base. This in turn takes them out of their comfort zone, enabling greater productivity. There are more such, Avagma did a 2013 survey on executive education in Indian organizations. It's available on the internet. If you would like to see, there are some very, very interesting pointers mentioned there on how executive education becomes important in organizations. What are the benefits? Yeah, we've been talking about executive education all along. What are the benefits? It helps in proper structured succession planning. Yeah? It helps as a retention and a motivational tool. There's best practice sharing through networking. Now, we were talking about open programs and customized programs for individuals within the organization. Open programs helps your people interact with people or industry stalwarts across the business, which in turn helps them for best practice sharing. If you're talking about internal or customized programs within the organization, it helps people interact with other departments more often, learn from them, and implement a lot of other ideas as well. We look at thought sharing within organization and the institute you have tied up with. Yeah? These institutes who provide executive education normally give you life case studies to do. And with these life case studies, organizations can actually take a lot of positive results. Because these case studies are discussed within the classroom with the subject matter experts in the institutes, and there is a lot of good results that come out of it. We also look at one very interesting feature is the customization as per the organization's needs and requirements. What is the cost of not doing it altogether? Yeah. There will be a lot of questions. Why do I need it? From an organization point of view, talent leakage is something that is very, very critical. Yeah. And executive education is one tool which will help you plug that. Now, a little while back, me and Graham were discussing about people leaving the organization anyway. Yeah, yes, they do. They leave the organization anyway. However, That risk cannot be completely eliminated, but mitigated to quite an extent by using this education as a tool. Because people look at developing themselves all throughout. Yeah? We have an employer brand image of attracting talent. Yeah? You attract more talent if you're able to give your future employees a lot of benefits. And this is probably taken as one of the biggest benefits across. Actually, as per one of Economic Times survey held in August, executive or professional development was one of the biggest reasons that employees said that they stay back with an organization. Yeah? Act local and think global. Yeah? A lot of these institutes today are providing you global education, global perspectives, yeah? Which will help you or which will help the local organizations to develop and improve their mindsets in a global perspective. We will have a robust leadership pipeline and a better change management and organization development in the, within the organization. Here's my conclusion of what I just presented to you, is that executive education is not about doing part-time executive MBA. It is about building leaders and visionaries who go beyond the conventional methods to innovate and strategize towards achieving organizational goals. Yeah, it's about sustaining business success. It's about having a competitive advantage. It's about developing and attracting talent. It's about personal goals being aligned with organizational goals, and it's about integration of skills. With this, I end my presentation here. Any questions that I would, or anybody would like? Yes.
Hi. Done on the topic of executive education, executive coaching. You know, in India, it is still seen, and as an executive coach, I've experienced that it is still seen as remedial.
Sorry?
It is still seen as remedial.
Okay.
People feel that if I'm being coached, that there's something wrong with me. So what is your take on it and how are things changing?
Yes. What he has asked is absolutely correct. Today, in our industries, in our kind of culture, not only about coaching, if I have to talk about training as a tool, people feel that there's something that I lack, because of which I'm being trained. If I talk about giving feedback, people feel that there's something wrong with me, that's why I'm giving the feedback. However, with the evolution that we're talking about, there's been a lot of cultural changes in the organization. Now, organizations are looking at training and development, executive coaching, as a developmental tool. And for that matter, a lot of the C-suite employees are actually accepting it as something which they can use to develop themselves also. So there is a personal goal which gets attached to it nowadays, and together with the organizational goal. Yes, the perspective is changing, but as we all know, change takes time. So I'm sure it will be some time by the time, probably we have a complete acceptance of these modules here. Anything else? Thank you so much.